Hi guys, here's Dora from Ultimate Success Coaches. Yes, it's again that time. Running Shoe Wishlist June 2021. This is one of my favorite videos series because it's so great to check what will be coming really soon on the market. And this video I think will be one of my favorites because two lines up from last year are coming up with the second version. And the first of these two lineups, which was one of my favorite shoes of 2020, was the ASICS Nova Blast. Yes, the second version is coming. I'm not sure whether it will be really a worldwide release or just a limited US release or maybe Asian release, but that's the date what I have seen, 20th of June. And ASICS was really listening. Thank you, ASICS, because they upgraded the shoe, which was already a great, great, great shoe. It's not for the reason that I'm saying it was one of my favorites. I would say even in the top three of last year. Just I bought it a bit late, so it was not my last year's review. Oh, I see. Just I'm kind of matchy-matchy with this neon green. Funny. The top layer. Let's start with the upper. It is updated as well. This is of course the first version, so it's not the second version. It will be a two-layer jacquard mesh upper, so it will be a bit different. We are also getting a gusseted tongue, so if you love a gusseted tongue, it will become a gusseted tongue. I had really no issues with this tongue either, but yes, if it's better, then even good. But I would say still the major update here is the drop, because it will be getting 2 additional millimeters in the forefoot, meaning it will be an 8 millimeter drop replacing the 10 millimeter drop. So if you are a forefoot striker, then you are getting a bit more energy return on that forefoot part, meaning 29 in the heel and 21 millimeter. That's the new stack height. Regarding the weight, I didn't really find that trustable source, but it seems to be really similar than the first version, so I'm not expecting too much there. Also, the midsole foam is staying the flight foam blast, which was really, really a win last year from ASICS, so I'm really happy that it's staying. They will also upgrade the laces, so that will be also something different. And also the heel counter will be more stable, TPU heel counter, so we can expect that it will be changing as well, which is great. And what I have seen in those first reviews from the early testers, that they are recommending to really size down with a half size. That was, if you remembered my videos, but I will put it up there for the ASICS Nova Blast version one video. I was also doubting whether my usual size should I buy or size down, but at the time I didn't size down. But if I'm buying the second version, I will definitely size down, because also for the summer with really thinner socks, have to size down here. So that will be the second version of the ASICS Nova Blast, and I put quite some pictures up there. There will be also lots of colors in the first series, it seems, and around the Olympic Games in July we can also expect some other colorways. The second shoe for today is a daily trainer from Hoka. I have never used this shoe before, and it's on my radar definitely for a max cushion daily trainer, and that's the Clifton 8 version. Now, Hoka had a Clifton 1, which was really, at the time, a super, super shoe. And after a few versions, they really went in other directions. And with the 6, I believe, it's really going back to that Clifton 1 successor type. So they really changed and went back to that old, good Clifton. Not too much changed since the 7 versions that I see the first reviews. Really, the midsole foam is still that EVA well-known midsole foam, but it's getting a bit upgraded. It will be a 15% lighter version. But I believe as well that Hoka should really, really find a new midsole foam, because this EVA is getting a bit odd. The energy return is not like a ASICS flight foam blast. No, EVA is good. It's trustable, but it's also nothing surprising, nothing really bouncy. So I would say that Clifton 8, if you need quite some protection, that can be a daily trainer, but don't expect too much from that shoe. Also, if I will be purchasing that shoe, that will be for me more an easy day shoe, and yeah, maybe a mid-distance running shoe, but also not really for a long tempo day. On the statistics for the men size, it will be 250 grams, for the ladies 215 grams, which is quite okay. I would say that's in the lighter edge of the daily trainers. And there will be a 5 mm drop, 29 mm stack height in the heel for the men, and 24 mm in the forefoot. So with the rocker sensation combined, okay, it's a daily trainer, but it will have some extra to that. We will see. And as third shoes for today is the Saucony Endorphin lineup, which will hit the markets on the 15th of June, so pretty soon, within 2 weeks. Yes, I'm totally excited for that, because that was my favorite lineup of 2020, and I expect that it will be still a hit in 2021, because it was just so high on everyone's agenda last year. Saucony did not change too many things. They have changed more or less only the upper. That's a bit of material change there. With the overlays, they were varying a bit, but they didn't really change that well-known and super, super lightweighted cushioned Powerrun PB midsole foam. And also the lineup will be the same. So for the carbon-plated shoe, that will be the Pro, the second version. For the daily tempo days, that will be the nylon-plated Speed 2. And that general daily trainer with some stability features, that will be the Shift version 2. And yeah, it's coming with a lot of colorways as well. You can see on the photos, some people say that this checkered upper, it's a bit too much. Yeah, it's not a minimalist upper, that's for sure. It's not a minimalist design, but if you are more for that minimalist design, you can go for that blue or black colorway example. I personally like the checkered colorway, because I used to have a training suit, a triathlon suit from Zoot a few years back, which was a bit of pink and this checkered flag combination, and I really loved it. Also, Nike has leaked some photos about maybe Nike by You colorways of the Vaporfly Next Percent version 2. So who knows, maybe the coming days that will be also available, and you can just design your own colorway of the Nike Vaporfly Next Percent version 2. We will see. Luckily, I would say, the past months I did not purchase any running shoes, because the Invisible was the last one I purchased in March, and yeah, I'm just around 100 km, so I can still put definitely 200-300 km in this shoe, easy miles, those middle distance runs, which I really hope that I can start soon after my injury. But it's on my list for June. That will be a tough choice, definitely, also with all the shoes coming in Olympic colorways as well. The ASICS Nova Blast version 2 is on my list, and either the Pro version 2 or the Speed version 2 is also definitely on my list. And I will see also how long this Invisible will be able to go for the distance. Maybe that Kryptonite as well? Yeah. It's really a great lineup for this review. It will be definitely difficult to choose one, which was my original aim with this video. What would be your choice? Let me know in the comment box below. I would be super interested in. Thank you for watching until the end, and see you in the next video. Bye. One more note. If your goal for the autumn is to run a 10 km PB or PR, different what you would like to call it, check out my website www.treyafharder.com, but I will also put the link in the comment box below, because I have a 10k PB run training plan available, which you can purchase, and I will send it for you, and then you can start really get ready for that PR run.